by the end of this video, you'll be able to find the area of a circle, the circumference of a circle, the surface area of a sphere, and the volume of a sphere. The circumference of a circle can also be known as the perimeter of a circle. In another video, you will learn how to find the area of a sector, the area of a segment, and the length of an arc. You can check out the video on parts of a circle. Let's start with area of a circle. Pi r squared is the most common known formula when finding the area of a circle, and this is when the radius is given. Other ways of finding the area of a circle is when the diameter is given and when the circumference is given. These two formulas are simply a modification of the first one. The units of area of a circle can be in millimeter squared or in centimeter squared or in inches squared or in meter squared or in feet squared. Each will depend on the unit of the radius or the diameter or the circumference. Let's find the area of the given circle with radius 14 meters. For the area of a circle with a given radius, we're going to use pi r squared. Hence, step number one, write out the formula for the area of a circle with a given radius, which is pi r squared. Next, we're going to substitute. We're going to take pi to be 3.142 and 14 squared is 196, and the area is 615.83 meters squared to 2 decimal places and to 5 significant figures. Next, let's find the area of the given circle with diameter of 50 centimeters. For the area of a circle with a given diameter, the formula is pi divided by 4 multiplied by the diameter squared. The area pi over 4 multiplied by the diameter squared was obtained from pi r squared. Remember, for any given circle, the diameter is the addition of the two radii. Hence, from this, that r will become diameter divided by 2. And wherever we see r, we're going to replace it with d over 2. Hence, instead of r, we're going to have d over 2. But remember that the r is squared. Hence, this will become squared. This 2 is going to square d, and the 2 will square the 2 at the denominator as well, and you're going to have pi multiplied by d squared divided by 4, which is exactly what we have here. Hence, the second formula is a modification of the first formula. After writing out the formula, the next step is to substitute. The area of this circle is 1963.75 centimeters squared to 2 decimal places and 6 significant figures. Next, let's find the area of the given circle with a circumference of 40 millimeters. For this circle, we have no given radius and no given diameter, but the perimeter, which is the same thing as the circumference, is 40 millimeters. The perimeter is the total length of the circle if you have to unroll it. With this, we can still find the area of the circle for the area with a given circumference. We're going to have the circumference squared divided by 4 pi. Likewise, this given formula is a modification of pi r squared. The formula for the circumference of a circle is 2 pi r, but the area of a circle is pi r squared. From the circumference of a circle, we are going to make r the subject. We are going to substitute the circumference divided by 2 pi into the area of a circle. Hence, in the area of a circle, instead of r, I will substitute c over 2 pi. And remember the squared. You are going to have pi multiplied by c squared, then 2 squared multiplied by pi squared. This pi will take away one of this pi at the denominator. And we are finally left with that the area is the circumference squared divided by 4 pi. Hence, we are going to use this area without the radius or the diameter. The first step is to write out the formula for the area of a circle with a given circumference. Next, we are going to substitute. If you substitute and solve carefully, the area of the circle is 127.31 millimeters squared to 2 decimal places and 5 significant figures. Next, the area of a circle is 153.94 inches squared. I would like to find the radius of this circle. The first step is to write out the area of a circle. The next step is to make r the subject. The next step is to substitute, and the radius is 7 inches. Next, let's consider how to calculate the circumference of a circle. Circumference can also be known as perimeter. The unit is in millimeters or in meters or in centimeters or in inches. The two formulas for calculating the circumference of a circle is 2 pi r or pi multiplied by the diameter. We use 2 pi r when we have a given radius, and we use pi multiplied by d when we have the diameter. Next, we're going to find the perimeter of this given circle of radius 12 centimeters. For the circumference or perimeter of a circle with given radius, we're going to use this formula. Next, we're going to substitute, and the circumference is 75.41 centimeters. Next, we're going to find the circumference of this circle with a given diameter. For the circumference of a circle with a given diameter, we're going to use pi multiply by the diameter. Next, we're going to substitute, and the circumference is 31.42 centimeters. To calculate for the circumference or perimeter of a circle, you're going to need either the radius or the diameter. Next, let's consider how to calculate the surface area of a sphere and the volume of a sphere. A sphere is simply a circle converted to three-dimensional shape. A sphere still have a diameter and a radius. For a sphere, we talk of the surface area, and the formula is 4 pi multiplied by r squared, and the volume of a sphere is 4 divided by 3 multiplied by pi multiplied by r to the power of 3. You can see, to calculate for the surface area of a sphere or the volume of a sphere, we need the radius. Let's find the surface area and the volume of the sphere with radius 8 millimeters. Since we have a given radius, for the surface area, we're going to use 4 multiplied by pi multiplied by r squared. The surface area of this sphere is 804.35 millimeters squared. Next, to calculate for the volume, we're going to use 4 over 3 multiplied by pi multiplied by r to the power of 3. And the volume of the sphere is 2144.94 millimeter cube. In the next video, we are going to look at area of a sector, area of a segment, and the length of an arc. If this video was helpful, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. To locate and access other helpful videos, follow the link on the screen. I will see you in the next video lesson.